us direction from above. We need a word.
In the midst from of the heaven, not just trials, but trials of many kinds.
Word from the Lord.
Oh, I ask you that when we word. Started out, that if you ever been through a divorce, if you ever been, have got a addiction, or if you ever been sick, if you ever been dead. But like I said before, many times we don't want to count that stuff. And there's no way we can count in that joy. But again, happiness is circumstantial, but joy is what's manifested on the inside of the Christian who is filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Come on. Amen.
It is the fruit of the Spirit.
That's right. That's right.
Spirit.
It's a spirit thing. So if you want to consider merriment in the face of many trials, which seems opposite of what we've been taught, opposite of what we believe, then you can only say what the old folk used to say, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me.
Come on now.
And if the world didn't give it to me, then the trials that I face of many kinds can't take it away.
All right.
Oh, are you ready to count tonight?
Count.
Oh, it's time for us to count. We've
yes,
been going too much, and we better learn how to count this way, because if you don't learn how to count this way, because we've been facing so many different kinds of trials, that either we're going to have the joy of the Lord, or some of us up in here is about to lose our mind. Hello? Hello? Consider merriment. Count joy. Oh, this is incredible. This is incredible. I'm trying to learn myself. I'm trying to learn. I said, boy, Lord, all the stuff that we've been going through, boy, I sure should be full of all kinds of joy. Oh, out of all the stuff that we're going through, Sunday's choir should be full. Oh, because they have so much joy that they want to sing about the joy of the Lord in the midst of their trials, in the midst of their troubles. Oh, the preacher should want to preach in the midst of their trials. All the ushers should want to usher because they're full of so much joy because they've been going through and facing so many kinds of trials that their joy should be overflowing right now. In Jesus' name.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In Jesus' name. Oh, I tend to see and know how the old folk really had, they used to talk about having religion, really had a personal relationship with Christ.
Yes, sir.
Because they would allow their trials to draw them closer into the Lord as opposed to being scattered.
Yeah, that's right.
Hello? And it would be a time in church or in our culture's history that when our nation was going through trials, the churches would be full. Oh, but it's not like that anymore. It seems like when we go through trials, the churches gets empty. And it really shows you really who you are depending upon. In the midst of your trials, it shows you really that you don't know how to count. Hello?
All right now.
That's an elementary thing to count, isn't it? To count to 10. That's elementary to know how to count. Let alone, God's not trying to subtract during the trials. It didn't say subtract the joy. Hello? He's trying to add something when we face all these trials of many kinds. He's trying to add something. But the only way he can add is you've got to have something on the inside of you.
Yeah. Amen.
The Holy Spirit of God.
Yes, sir.
And you've got to not grieve him in times of trouble. You got to learn to consider joy. Say to your neighbor again, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
This joy.
This joy.
That I have.
That I have.
The world didn't give
the
it.
World didn't give it to
and
me.
The world can't,
and the world can't take it away.
In Jesus' name. This person says, be Mary, really Mary. The life of a true Christian should be a perpetual jubilee, a prelude to the festivals of eternity. Hello. 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 Be Mary in the midst of your trials. Be Mary in the midst of the various kinds of trials, the various kinds of situations. As a matter of fact, you need to consider pure joy. My brothers, whenever you face the kind of joy, the trials that we are going through, God is trying to manifest true joy. So consider merriment, but also consider what?
Moxie.
Moxie. Moxie. You say, preacher, you use that word again. What does that word mean? Moxie. That's the word that we interjected or took out for perseverance. It says, because you know that the testing of your faith develops persevering. The testing of your faith develops perseverance. And many times when many of us face the various trials that we have been facing, the loss of loved ones, many times Christian folk who say they're Christians want to give up on God.
Yeah.
They want to give up on God because they're mad at God because God didn't do what they thought he should do. Oh, and many times people, when they face the various trials, they get upset and say, good God wouldn't have allowed bad to happen. Why does God allow bad things to happen? And they get upset and they get mad at God and they quit on God. Walk away from the faith when God is trying to get you to persevere in the race. Not walk away from the faith.
That's it.
He's trying to get you to persevere. There's some who are going through various trials right now. And not only will they give up their spiritual life, but some get so depressed that they want to give up their physical life and consider suicide as opposed to considering joy.
Yeah.
They're going through various trials, really trials that really, if we tell the truth, all of us are going through, or will go through. All of us will lose a loved one. All of us will, and all of us have. It is appointed once for man to die.
Yes, sir.
And for the Christian, to die is a precious thing in the sight of the Lord.
Yeah, right.
And many of us get mad at God because he took that person before that time. Wait a minute. Who's God? Who's God? Who sets the time on life? God says that I formed you in your mother's womb before you even had any thought. Your mother and daddy had even thought of you, alone aunties, cousins, and all of them. I formed you in your mother. I sent you to the earth. I planned the days of your life. Who are you to question God?
Yeah,
sir.
Hello? Who are you to be mad at God for what he did or what he didn't do? One thing, many of us, we talk about Job, but we don't talk about that really, that in-between time when Job had the audacity to question God. And then God gave him a pop quiz.
Where were you?
The calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within. And give us direction from above.